Fixed annuities are fantastic products in low interest, low inflationary, even deflationary economies. That's just a fact, my friend. But there are a couple things you've got to be looking out for, which we're going to go into here right now. All right, so first and foremost, I'll never forget when I worked at USAA. We had three fixed annuity products, a 2, a 5, and a 10-year one. The 2 is paying 4.5. The 5 was paying, I want to say 5, and the 10-year was paying 6%. This is in 2009 and 2010. Now, you had to be careful laddering annuities. That was a great strategy, but you had to be careful if you did it outside an IRA. And I always tell people, just be advised, annuities are always best owned in an IRA. When people say, you're not getting double tax deferral. No, you're not getting double tax deferral, but you are getting the tax deferral, which means you could transfer annuity products from product A to product B to product C, all in the context of the under the IRA umbrella without paying taxes on the gains you've had, which is huge. I've done other videos on this. I won't go into this too much. I'm just telling you right now, man, fixed annuities, variable annuities should always be done in an IRA if you can. Always, always, always. Anyway, so I remember I had this one guy and he wanted to do these 10-year fixed annuities at USA. It was paying 6%. This is 2009 or 10. And just like everybody, I said, don't do it, man. Inflation, the government spending is inflation, because I was such a fool like everybody else was. I bought into the inflation is always and everywhere a monetary phenomenon. Too much money chasing too few goods. But the problem with that equation is the too much money. Let me let my dog out. Hold on a second. So wrapped under the first part of that equation, too much money, that we forget the second part of that equation, too few goods. And we haven't had too few goods in the United States for a long time. We haven't, because of the way the global transactional economy is. It's bad. It's going to come to a crashing halt at some point, I grant you, or most likely. As you can see, just a just-in-time inventory and all this stuff. The minute there is a bottleneck in the supply chains, everything goes corrupt and there's way too few goods. But we haven't had that. By and large, we shouldn't expect that for most consumer goods that we have. We just shouldn't. So with that said, the too much money chasing too few goods, yes, there's a lot of money, but there's a whole lot more goods being produced than the too much money. And as such, it's deflationary. It's just that simple, man. And but we all got caught up in too much money chasing too few goods. That's Milton Friedman. And we were wrong, because the too few goods never came to fruition. It was always too much money, or too much money chasing too much more goods, which is inherently deflationary. And so I remember this one guy, he bought these, he must have had $1 million, that 10-year fixed annuity at USA paying 6%. Fast forward to 2017 or so, he still had 3 more years left of the contract. I was like, I'll never forget, he lived right here in Georgia. He's like, man, I'm making $60,000 a year guaranteed by USAA. All right, but anyway, so that is fantastic, because the USA products were simple. You got 4.5, you got 5, or you got 6. That's simple. No ifs, ands, or buts. If you took money out more than 10% a year, you'd pay a surrender charge on the amount you took out more than 10% a year up to a certain point. It's so simple, man. Keep it simple, stupid. You don't want to do laddered annuities in a non-IRA contract, because what's called a serial contract tax. And I'm not going to get into that here. I had no idea what that was when I first went to USAA. Look, I was a CFP, 10 years experience. I remember I was telling people, hey, you should do these ladder CDs, 1 to 2, 1 to 5, 1 to 10. I never get my man, David Tedesco, RIP, my brother. He said, hey, and because we're on a call center. He overheard me. He goes, oh, you should be careful doing that. I said, why? He goes, because of serial contract tax. I said, what the hell is that? Look it up if you're interested. It's nuts. I said, I never knew about that. It's crazy. You don't know what you don't know. All right. But anyway, one thing I want to share with you on a fixed annuity. So we're going to show you, here's a what's going on right now. My man John had emailed me. He's saying his CDs are coming due. What should he, look at a multi-year guaranteed annuity? And we're going to talk about this, and just because he's saying he could get one for 2.7. I said, man, that's pretty good. I was wondering what the term was. Hold on just a second. So I said, let me see what the 10-year treasury bond is doing right now. 1.56. All right, so it looks like the 10-year treasury is now kind of stabilized. Basically since March is stable. It has stabilized for sure. Since beginning of April, so we've had April, May, June. We're in our third month of roughly right about 1.6. So it looks like the 10-year treasury has stabilized about 1.6. What's the 30-year doing? Hold on just a second. The 30-year is doing about 2.239. It looks like same thing, stable. Yep, the same thing. So we've had some stabilization of the rates not jumping up anymore. And so when he's saying he's getting a five, I think he said he didn't tell me 5 year. I assume it's a 5 year guaranteed fixed annuity at 2.7. Pablo's back. I said, that sounds pretty good given the 10-year treasury is only 1.6. So I said, let's look at the rates right now. And this is all things annuity. Don't know the first thing about this company. It just came up in my DuckDuckGo search. Multi-year guaranteed annuities. I'm going to show you the rates here. So we go down to see the rates. Oops, one sec. We go due to the rates. Where are the rates? One sec. Oh, right here. All right. So we're going to go to 5 year. We're going to click on this thing right here and look at the rates. All right. So what we're going to see here, is we have rates of 3%. We got these asterisks, two asterisks, 2.8, 2.7. But the notice, they all say MVA, market value adjustment. They all say that. MVA. So we got 2. I mean, why don't we got 2.1% at American National Palladium, and then we got a 3%. I mean, that's a pretty significant difference. What does the MVA mean? And this is what you get. Anytime you see that those three letters MVA, you should run for the hills. In my opinion, run for the hills. Now let's see what the asterisks say here. By the way, I guarantee it's below. All right, so. I can't see where the asterisks. Do they even have the asterisks on here? Hold on a sec. I couldn't even find what the they didn't even put on here what the asterisks mean that I could tell. All right. So anyway, that was bothersome. All right. So we go to what does MVA mean? Market value adjustment. And here's annuityadvisors.com. A market value adjustment can be attached to a deferred annuity that features fixed interest rate guarantees combined with an interest rate adjustment that could cause the actual crediting rates to increase or decrease in response to market conditions. Generally, the MVA will only apply to the amount withdrawn in excess of the free withdrawal provision stated in the contract. All right, so what is happening here? If interest rates are higher at the time of the withdrawal than when the contract is purchased, a negative market value adjustment will apply. If interest rates are lower, I mean, just the complexity just drives you crazy. All right, so the market value adjustment seeks to protect the insurance company against investment loss incurred by early withdrawals. By having a more predictable pattern of withdrawals, MVA annuities have a greater potential to credit higher interest rates than a traditional fixed annuity. Now, this is dated to 2012, so it's going on 10 years old. But here, the market value adjustment protects the insurance company. Huh? So anytime they're protecting the insurance company, it always makes my hair on my back of my Rhodesian Ridgeback mutt over there, Finney, rise. Because he's saying, whoa, whoa, whoa. And to protect the insurance company, usually has negative ramifications on protecting the insurer, the investor, in my opinion. And I don't like that because we don't know. I mean, so you're subject to what the insurance company tells you from later on. No, we don't want that. So, I mean, I'm telling you right now, man, that's not a good place to be. I guarantee there'll be an annuity guy on here say, oh, but historically, look, I get that. However, anytime something can be an adjustment in order to protect the insurance company, it bothers me. So let's look at something else here. Hold on a second. All right, so here are the rates at USAA. They don't, well, at least they don't think they do market value adjustments. They didn't for many years. But here we got 10-year and a 5-year, 1.6 and 1.65 for the 10-year. Fixed guaranteed annuity. And you can see right here, you put $1 million in there, it's paying more than 1.95. That's on a 5-year. You put 50,000, it's only paying 1.6. Minimum guaranteed interest rates. You can see. So this is a fixed annuity from USAA, which is one of the strongest insurance companies out there, paying 1.6. Now, are they doing that to rob their members? Maybe. I highly suspect they're not because the members literally own the company. Isn't that right, Pablo? Look at that dog. I don't think that's going on. I think what's happening here is the other annuity companies are using MVAs to juice their returns that might not be sustainable, if that makes sense. Because remember, what do annuities buy? They buy guaranteed government bonds and highly rated corporate bonds. That's what they're buying, man. And I mean, if we're only getting a 10-year government bond at 2.2, and a 10-year government bond at 1.56, how is an annuity company giving you 2.7? Think about that, man. It's just USAA. Maybe they're not the best rated in town in terms of the interest rates they're getting, but for they're a strong company, they're member owned, they're not traded on Wall Street, and they're only giving you one, what did we say, 1.6? So if I'm seeing 2.7, and I'm seeing those the catchphrase MVA in there, I'm getting a little bit concerned there for sure. So anyway, I like fixed annuities, just be careful. All right, I'd like to hear your thoughts. Thanks now.